somebody asked me on a clinic last week, hey, what do you practice if you only have 2 hours in 1 week? Like, you have a family and you have a job and you have responsibilities and all this stuff, and you only get to the bass or whatever instrument for 2 hours in 1 week. And I said, well, you have a job. He said, yes. I said, do you drive to work? Yes. How long is your commute? 1 hour in the morning, 1 hour in the evening. I said, well, you've got a radio in your car, right? Yes. I said, well, why are you not listening to the radio and figuring stuff out? You know what I mean? It's something that's constant for me. The way the bus pulls up, you know, I can hear melody in pretty much everything, and that's I'm trying to assimilate that in every chance I get. You know, when we're kids, when we're infants, you pour all this information in, and it sticks. It's like a sponge, you know, like you soak it up. So you use a lot more of your brain when you're a child, and now I'm not 103 years old, but I'm 32 and I'm not 6 years old anymore. So I have to pour a lot of information in because most of it leaks out the other side. So I pour lots in and a little bit stays and most of it ends up on the floor.
So if you don't mind, how about doing like a traffic improvisation? Just on traffic, that's something that's typical to where you live, right? So traffic noise, cars.
A traffic improvisation. About eight years ago, Victor Wooten was asked to do a September 11th improvisation. Man, it was one of the baddest things I've ever seen. And I remember that, and I was like, damn, somebody at some point is going to ask me to do something like that. And here it is.
Putting you on the spot.
I have prepared nothing. Okay, traffic improvisation, okay.
Thank you.
There was some traffic in there, I think.